the 6 million Americans that visit hospitals with broken bones each year. About 500,000 patients require long hospital stays and are at risk for long-term disability because of severe bone loss. When a soldier suffers a blast injury during combat, or a person gets into a car accident on the highway, the extent of tissue damage can be so severe that the body cannot heal itself. This is a very challenging problem for orthopedic surgeons. So what can surgeons do in this case? Well, we know that bone can repair itself in cases of less damage. What if we could stimulate the body to regrow damaged bones in cases of more traumatic injury as well? The body uses a class of proteins known as bone morphogenetic proteins, or BMPs, in order to stimulate cells to grow bone. Consequently, we can deliver BMP to the body in order to heal large bone defects. But the key piece that is missing is the delivery method, and that's where my research comes in. Currently, orthopedic surgeons deliver BMP by soaking it into a very porous sponge made out of collagen. This BMP is not strongly bound to the material and rapidly leaves the injury site within hours, being completely broken down within days. This can cause side effects, including inflammation, cancer, and bone formation elsewhere in the body. For my PhD thesis, I'm working on developing microparticles made out of heparin in order to better localize BMP directly to the bone defect site over the entire period of healing. You may have heard of heparin before because it's commonly used as a blood thinner after heart attacks. But what you might not know is that heparin can also very strongly bind to proteins such as BMP. This new technology has two main advantages. Firstly, heparin microparticles are tiny microscopic gels, which means that millions of them filled with BMP can easily be injected through a syringe directly to a bone defect site. Secondly, when heparin microparticles and BMP are mixed, we can achieve over 90% binding in just a few hours. And unlike the collagen sponge, these microparticles tightly hold on to the BMP for several weeks. Right now, we are in the process of testing these microparticles filled with BMP in bone defects in the legs of rats. And as you can see from these X-ray images here, there is a striking difference between the bones that have been treated and those that haven't been treated, where the treated bones are completely regenerated in just 8 weeks. By using heparin to solve a clinical problem, we are harnessing a natural biological process to correct a situation where the normal biology of the body fails. We know that heparin can also bind a number of other proteins, which means that one day, this technology may have tremendous potential for other applications, such as healing skin wounds, muscle defects, or even cardiovascular disorders. Bone is just the start. Thank you.